Hello students, welcome to the session. Today we'll discuss regarding the acupuncture management for migraine. In modern physiology or in conventional medicine, the pathophysiology is explained related to the functions of the brain. But in TCM, in traditional Chinese medicine, the causes for headache is looked with different perspectives. There are different causes for headache, so they are called as exogenous as well as endogenous factors. Head being the junction point for all the yang channels of the head and foot, there is also a upward energy flow circuit, energy that is qi and blood flow through the six Fu and five yang organs. Any dysregulations in the flow of energy, there is a dysregulation of the meridian functions, which results in headache or other symptoms. So the correction also can be done by stimulating the energy channels to enhance the flow of blood and the qi to the brain area, where we can regulate the functions of the brain. The main causes considered are the external causes as well as the internal causes. Among the external causes, they are called as exogenous causes. They are wind cold, wind heat, and wind damp. So the deficient internal conditions, so there is one, qi deficiency, that is primarily from the overwork mentally and or physically. So blood deficiency primarily affect after the long term illness where the body has been weakened, and the third one is kidney deficiency, primarily from old age or excessive sexual activities. So let us see what is wind cold. So excess signs and symptoms. So based on the signs and symptoms, we can select the points accordingly. So the symptoms of wind cold. Wind is one of the exogenic pathogenic factor. So here it represents in the form of distending, pulling sensation in the head. It may be, there may be a feeling of tightness along the posterior aspect of the head. Common wind cold symptoms such as chills, stuffy nose, or body aches may arise due to even allergies in the spring season or during the change in the seasons. So when we look at the tongue, you can see the change in the color, that is thin white coated tongue is representation of wind cold. Pulse, when we feel the pulse, when we palpate the pulse, we may feel floating or tight pulse. So now what are the points used for this kind, that is wind cold? So one point is from the gallbladder meridian, that is GB20, which helps to clear the wind. Next is UB12, that is wind shoe. It is the point used for clearing the wind. The meridian corresponding is UB. The point is located at the level of second thoracic vertebra, 1.5 chun lateral to the midline. Lung 7, so it's one of the very important distal point which corresponds to the head and posterior aspect of the neck, so which even helps to clear the wind. So here the next point, so one of the common point which is almost always used is LI4, which is also a potent analgesic point. It helps in releasing the exterior wind or wind cold. So UB10, that is just at the apex nape of the neck, 0.5 chun inside the natural hairline and 0.3 chun lateral to the midline. It is mainly used to release the exterior wind. So next external causative factor is wind heat. So excess wind heat. What are the signs and symptoms? Mainly there is a splitting kind of headache, then associated with heat signs such as red face or eyes, sometimes associated with fever, thirst. When we look at the tongue, we may feel red, possibly white or thin yellow coated tongue. Pulse may be of floating and it is fast. treatment options. So large intestine 4 mainly helps to clear the heat and release the exterior. Next, large intestine 11, again it helps to clear the heat. It is one of the potent homeostatic, immune enhancing as well as a tonification point. GV14, governing vessel 14, again it helps to release the exterior and also clear the heat. Apart from that, it is one of the potent immune enhancing point. GB20, gallbladder 20, which is very easy to locate, which is located at the apex of the posterior triangle, which helps to clear the wind from the head region. Then one more point, TH5, that is triple warmer 5, which is located 2 chin proximal to the midpoint of the dorsal wrist crease, again helps to release the exterior and clear the heat. The third pathogenic factor, that is wind damp. So what are the symptoms? So we may feel as a towel tightly wrapped or a band tightly wrapped around the head. There is heaviness in the body. The appetite may be very poor and there may be chest discomfort also. When we look at the tongue, there is greasy coat on the tongue, and the pulse when we palpate, it may be soft or even slippery. Now the points corresponding are like GV20, which helps to clear the head, clear the heat or pathogen from the head. Then CV12, this is the mucifront point for stomach also. Location, it is 4 chin above the center of the umbilicus. Then UB20, again it is a show point for spleen, which activates the spleen. Stomach 36, that is again helps for tonification of spleen and stomach. And stomach 40, which is located 5 chin below the tip of the tibial tuberosity and one finger breadth lateral, which helps in resolving the dampness. GB20, again similar to the previous condition, that is it helps to clear the wind from the head. Now the very important point, it's an endogenous factor, just from the liver, especially in conventional or in physiology it is explained as metabolic changes. So here there is a yang rising, liver yang rising, that is excess internal factors. The signs and symptoms are: there may be severe headache, usually worse in the afternoon, may be pulsatile or accompanied by the appearance of the blue or prominent vein over the forehead or over the temporal region. Headache is usually seen bilateral here. Sometimes it may be one side. Pain may be worsening while lying down. So patient may have a quick temper, irritability, and the taste may be bitter in the mouth. Red face and also associated with constipation is a sign of liver yang rising. So it may also affect the stomach, leading to nausea or vomiting. The tongue may look red or yellow coat, and pulse may be wiry and also it may be forceful. The treatment options here are liver 3, which is the urine source point of the liver meridian, which helps in solving the liver stagnation, which is located 2 chin proximal to the web space of the first and second toes. Then spleen 6 helps to tonify the yin of the spleen, and kidney 3 tonify the yin. Then GB4, gallbladder 4, which is helpful for headache. GB20, which helps to descend the chi from the head. And the GB43 point, clear the heat from the GB channel. And Tai Yang, which is helping to reduce the pain in the head region. If there is involvement of the stomach, then we may have to use pericardium 6, GB34, CV12 and stomach 36. Now, the other three factors will be continued in the next session. Thank you.